when I went to Zimbabwe to report. It was the parched heart of the dry season, with even the hope of rains a good 2 months away. And where I was in northern Matabele land, which is the poorest province in a very, very poor country. And yet, I saw so much to give me hope. There were people who had been on food aid for a long time, and now they were able to feed themselves. The main river in the area had extended, the water cycle had been had improved, and so the Dimbangombe River was now a full kilometer higher. And I went to see where this was, and there were reeds and fish eagles, plants and animals and bird life that is only present when there's a lot of moisture. So what made this difference? The Africa Center for Holistic Management and the villages where they worked, they were applying something called holistic planned grazing, which is basically managing animals, livestock, in a way that restores the land, basically in a way so that the animal's behavior mimics that of the giant, great animal herds that used to roam the savannas of southern Africa. And in so doing, the animals act upon the land in a way that jumpstarts many biological processes. I think this is important, and I really wanted to pursue this article because so often when we're dealing in the natural world, we've become so in love with technology and numbers and measurements and figures and studies, and the basic observation of what is happening on the land sometimes just kind of gets sloughed off. So I wanted to bring that out, to talk to trackers, people who have really spent so much of their time understanding this as a science, as an art, as a way of life, a way of interacting with the natural world. And that's what I was able to do in this piece. Just a little anecdote about that Alan Savory and his tracking. When I first spoke to him about this, he explained how he became a tracker, and he casually mentioned that in the 1950s his work was to track rogue elephants and man-eating lions. And I'm writing this down, and I thought, oh my gosh, man-eating lions. I mean, you know, kind of, you think of that, you know, in fiction, but yes, these were lions that were marauding in villages for various reasons. And so Alan explained that with the National Conservation Service that he was working with in what was then Northern Rhodesia, that they worked with expert African trackers. But Alan came to see that whenever they came close to a lion, the expert trackers lost the track. So he realized that out of logical self-preservation, they were intentionally losing the track. So he decided that if he is going to fulfill his task of protecting rural villagers from lions that may be, killing people, that he needed to learn how to track himself. So I thought that was rather a telling story. So the other piece that I did was about the interrelationship of poverty reduction and conservation. When we think about conservation in an area where there's a lot of wildlife, we often think that we need to portion off land, let that land alone, don't let people there, don't manage that land actively. But what I saw was that by managing the land according to holistic planned grazing in a restorative fashion, that this was helping people get out of abject poverty and also to promote conservation and the habitat for wildlife.